bunch of songs and not give you a chance to meet Jesus. It's like coming to my house. If you came to my house and I were to talk about this great meal that I prepared, I'd want you to partake of that meal. We're here to tell you Jesus is the answer. We've already said it, we've sung it, and you can believe it. He's the answer. There's a lot of people that walk around and they don't know where they're going to be when they're dead and gone. Nothing any more sad than to go to a funeral and them say, well, we think that he was a believer, or we think that she was saved. Don't know for sure, but we think. How sad it is not to know for sure. Maybe you're here tonight and you can say, I don't know. I do not remember a time that I've asked Jesus to come into my heart to forgive me of my sin and save me, and I need to be sure. Would you bow your heads, please? Not going to call you out, not going to embarrass you, but I want to say this. We've encountered a supernatural power of the Holy Spirit tonight like I haven't felt in a long time. If you're here tonight and you can say, Karen, it's time. I need to stop worrying about what everybody thinks, and I need to get myself straightened out with the Lord right here and now. I need to know for sure that I'm saved. I'm going to repeat what I repeated the first of this night. The Bible says the only way that you get to heaven is through the blood of Jesus. That if you believe on Jesus, you shall be saved. And you're here tonight and say, Karen, please remember me. I need to be sure that I'm saved. Would you slip up your hand? Come on, slip it up. God bless you. Oh, yeah. Yes, yes. Anybody else? We see that. Yes, yes, yes. Anybody else? I need to be sure. Anybody else? Anybody else? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Anybody else? Anybody else? Roll away. Now, we're going to say a prayer in just a moment. But we want to give you a chance. For those who, there were quite a few who raised your hands. If you want to come down, we'll pray with you. We just want to give you that chance. This is a praying church right here. Just want to give you that opportunity. If you want to step out of your seat, there's something special about coming down to an altar and praying. It's just special. We just want to give you that chance right now. Would you come out of your seat? Would you step out of your seats? Would you come?
And save me. And from this day forward, I will
And I will trust you as my Lord and Savior. Thank you, Jesus, for securing me a place in heaven. Thank you, Jesus, for saving my soul. While heads are still bowed and no one's looking, the Bible says we're supposed to confess the Lord Jesus. We're not to be ashamed. If you've been doubting your salvation, that you prayed that prayer from your heart and you really feel like you settled your salvation here tonight, would you slip up your hand and say, I really feel like I settled it tonight. Settled my salvation. Would you slip up your hand and put right back down here? God bless you. 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 God bless you in the back. Hands everywhere. But let me say this to those who raise your hands. Make sure that you go to someone that you traveled with tonight and tell someone what the Lord has done for you. Go to the pastor if you can. Tell the pastor, I settled my salvation here tonight. If you don't have a home church, come to this one. This is a good one right here. And learn more about Jesus. Father, we give you the praise, the honor, and the glory in Jesus' name. And let me just say this. Let's sing this one more time. I surrender all. How many can say here tonight that you are surrendering something to the Lord here tonight? Would you slip up your hand?
To thee, my blessed.
precious son, Jesus. Everybody said.
God's here tonight. And you got to be dead not through His presence. Feel the Shekinah glory. That same glory that fell on the tabernacle in the Old Testament. Precept just hang back and wait outside because the glory of the Lord filled that place. I feel that same Shekinah glory here tonight. Anybody enjoying this as much as I am? This is good stuff. Glad to have all of our guests here tonight. And some of you wish this would go on, and some of you probably can't wait to get out of here quick enough. Maybe we scared some of you. I think we've been good tonight up to a while. When they got on that wear the crown or what, I forget the name, the words of it, I was like, uh-oh. This is dangerous. I felt God's glory here tonight. I make no apologies about what we feel here tonight. We're glad to have these men from the labor of the fields. These men have just come off of a drug addiction. And man, I tell you, they're all doing wonderful work. They keep them confined back there. One of the young men came down, Kevin, to pray with him. I said, you saved? He said, yeah, but I just need to make sure. So we prayed. And I said, man, I'm so proud of you. He said, I really felt the urge to run a while ago. He said, I'm afraid I'd get in trouble and get on to me. You know what? I turned on the football game last night, Clemson and Auburn. First thing I saw when that game come, matter of fact, I was at home watching it. I didn't want to battle the crowd. First thing they showed, there was a wave of people. Must have been 80, 90. I don't know. I mean, that place all now, Jimmy. Just a wave of people going crazy, just losing their mind, so excited over a little ball made out of big skin. I got thinking that ball ain't done a thing for me. If I can't get a little excited and thank God for what He did on Calvary's cross. I'm glad we're able. I'm glad to feel that freedom here tonight. I really am. Now I'm glad you're standing because I'm really here to receive an offering, and you get your wallet a whole lot better when you're standing than when you're seated down. The Bible reminds us that a servant is worthy of their hire. How many knows that? How many knows you can't do too much for people that are out on the cutting edges, that are giving their heart and life for ministry? We need more of this right here now. You get entertainment all day long, but they're not entertaining tonight. This is ministry. You can't invest too much in this tonight. That's right. Give God praise here. I want Roy and Stanley to come around. Maybe Stanley, while you're getting prepared to give, I want you to give just out of the leading of your heart. Some of you can give a lot. God bless some of you. Just give out of the abundance of God's blessing. If He's blessed a lot and you can give, you can't give too much. No way we can ever understand what it costs to keep a group like this on the road. Hundreds of thousands of dollars a year. And I promise you what you sow tonight, God will return. And He'll give that back tenfold, if not more. Father, we honor you. We thank you here tonight for your blessings. Thankful for this group, God, that has been led by the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Father, I feel such a deep reverence here tonight, and I know there's no way that we can measure the spiritual aspect and the impact that you've had on this service. But God, I believe lives have been changed. I know souls have been saved. People have been delivered, brought out of darkness into this marvelous light. And God, no way that we can ever pay for what we feel tonight. We'd go bankrupt. But God, we do give out of the abundance of our heart, and everything that is given in here tonight goes directly to bless this group that you've anointed here tonight. We know that you'll bless the gift, and you'll bless the giver as well. For this, we give you honor. Amen and amen. There's more to come. Just prepare to give. God bless you tonight. Lord, y'all do something. Y'all will see. All right.
Sing it to me. You have no threat. I'll be honest, I love this whole room. Teresa, I have to say this. Susan, I'm sorry, I call you Teresa. I still love you, don't I know your name? I really didn't know your name. That just went straight through my brain. I didn't even know I did it. Can you have me a stand? Or somebody, I just want to put it on a stand. I've never known anybody in my life that loves singing more than Karen Peck. What's that you say? Sometimes you said, I just love my boss. I got the best boss man in the world. I think that's what you said. Good retirement plan and the best boss man in the world. And I wish my voice could do this like I would want to do this for you. But it's an old song, but I don't know. Last thing I would have done tonight was sing this. But this is the way I feel about you. Born to serve the Lord.
Oh,
years old. I was in the fifth grade, and Susan was in the eighth grade, and our little neighbor was in the seventh grade. And we started a little girls' trio called The Joyful Noise, and that was one of the first songs we ever sang. And I was 10 years old. Born to serve. Would you sing that one more, that chorus more? Have you ever in your born days heard anything like this woman right here?
Stay if you want to. Stay all night, stay a little longer if you like to.